good credit is an important part of financial health these days. You can't lease a car or get a mortgage without it. This year, changes are being made in how some scores are calculated, making loans more available and cheaper for many, too. Joining us right now with the details is senior personal finance correspondent Sharon Epperson. And Sharon, what are the new programs that are being rolled out?
Well, there are several new programs being rolled out. And the good news is when you boost your score, you are likely to get a lower interest payment that you have to pay on the money that you're borrowing. And so that can save you a lot. So you want to look into two new programs. One is being launched by Experian. It's called Experian Boost, and it's supposed to go into full effect by the summertime. What it will do, it will look at what your bank history is in terms of the bills that you're paying for your phone and your utility payments. So it's factoring in phone and utility payment history, which really hasn't been done much before. And it can update your score instantly by doing that. It's a good thing for a lot of young consumers who may not have much credit history yet in a way to get that credit history going. The other one is Ultra FICO. Ultra FICO by FICO, which is the company that everyone knows for your FICO score. They're also looking at your bank history, but they're looking at your balances and your cash flow. Both of these programs are programs that you have to opt into, but this is another way that you may be able to boost your score by looking at things that hadn't been counted before, your checking and your savings account balances being them.
When you start talking about looking at utility bills and things on the first program, Experian Boost, is that for people who don't pay on time or who had one bill that they paid late or something, or is this for somebody who really doesn't have any credit history?
It's geared to people who have limited credit history and those who are kind of in that gray area when it comes to their credit score. The average credit score has been going up, which is great news. It's over 700 now on average.
Wow.
But for people who are in those maybe the high 500s, low 600 range, these programs are for them to help them boost their score. And there's still millions and millions of Americans out there that have no credit history with any of the major credit bureaus, but you do have a phone and you have your utility payments. And if you're paying those bills with your bank account balances, then this is a way to track you and this could help you out.
If you don't participate in one of these programs, are there still ways that you can boost your credit score?
You have to do the three things that always matter when it comes to your credit. You have to pay your bills on time every time.
Oh, I mean,
it's just as simple as that. Keep your balances low and then also apply for credit when you really need it. Limit those credit applications, those inquiries into your credit as well. Doing those things over and over again is another great way to boost your score. If you want to opt into these programs and you think they'll work for you, that's terrific. But those three things are really what's going to make the difference.
I would say, just to emphasize what you're talking about, every time you walk into a store and they offer you 20% off on that purchase if you open a credit card, don't do it.
Don't
that can cost
it.
You
don't
over the long run.
Exactly.
Just because of the number of credit card lines that you have open at
that
point.
You need no more than two credit cards.
That's right. Sharon, thank you.
Sure.
Sharon Epperson.